global chip shortage. It has been almost a year now, and contrary to the most optimistic predictions, the global chip shortage doesn't look like it's going to be easing up anytime soon. From the reports we are getting, and according to Susquehanna Financial Group, wait times for chip deliveries was about 19 weeks a few months ago. But by late October 2021, if you placed an order for electronic chips, you get an estimated time of delivery that's about 22 weeks long. It's even longer for scarcer parts. For instance, at the moment, it takes about 25 weeks for power management chips to be delivered. It gets worse for the auto industry, who are in a dire need of microcontrollers, that currently takes an average of 38 weeks for delivery. The painful reality is that the global semiconductor shortage is getting worse as delivery times are getting longer. The demand for chips did not go down as predicted by experts. Buyers are also hoarding the chips they've got, hoping to outlast the scarcity. And to make things worse, production factories are also facing unpredictable hiccups, preventing them from running at full capacity. In summary, this is a nightmare for many tech companies, especially auto manufacturers. Recently, General Motors and Ford Motors both reported step drops in profit for the third quarter of the year, which is largely due to the shortage of chips that has greatly reduced output. Even Tesla, the electric vehicle giant who previously had well-established supply chains for auto parts, including semiconductor chips, have recently reported that they are experiencing challenges in meeting customer demands, and the lack of expected outputs is hampering the revenue growth of the company. Apple has not avoided the struggle either. Despite posting a record 12-month profit, the tech giant have warned that supply chain disruptions in relation to chip shortages are hindering product manufacturing ahead of the Christmas holidays. Essentially, everyone is feeling it. As a result of this global shortage, the smartphone industry is expected to grow just by 6%. That's half the initial forecast that was given earlier in 2021. I know. The question you might be asking, how did it get to this point? Well, to answer that question, we must first understand what exactly caused this shortage in the first place. The chip shortage we are currently experiencing was kickstarted by the COVID-19 pandemic and the lockdowns that came with it. As you would expect, with the majority of the population working or schooling from home, the demand for electronic equipment like laptops and servers rapidly increased. And with that increase, the production of this equipment also ramped up, leading to massive demand for semiconductor chips. Between 2018 and 2019, semiconductor sales declined globally. However, in 2020, sales increased by 6.5%. And according to the Semiconductor Industry Association, this trend is continuing in 2020. What we have on our hands is a classic scenario of demand far exceeding supply, as manufacturers are desperately struggling to keep up. This whole conundrum has exposed a serious weak point in the global chip supply chain. The problem is that the bulk of the manufacturing of semiconductor chips rests on two main companies, Taiwan's TSMC and South Korea's Samsung. When it comes to the cutting-edge chip development, especially for mobile devices and military applications, no other company comes close to these two. As if the enormous demand for semiconductors was not challenging enough, to make matters worse, Taiwan just suffered their worst drought in over 50 years. You might be wondering what chip production has to do with droughts. Well, the production of semiconductors requires a lot of water for cooling processes. As a result, the availability of water is crucial to chip production. With Taiwan struggling for ample water supply, the Taiwan-based chip production company TSMC, which is also the largest chip production company in the world, found itself in a precarious situation. Not only could the company not meet up with demands, now it was struggling to even run at full capacity, thanks to the water scarcity. But while the enormous demand for chips and the Taiwan drought are two of the biggest challenges in the industry at the moment, there are other small factors as well. Fire outbreaks in certain factories have also amplified the shortage, as well as power outages and transportation blockages. So what are companies doing to solve the global chip shortage? As you can already appreciate, the global chip shortage is the complex one. There are fundamental deficiencies within the industry supply chain that simply cannot be fixed in a matter of months. Initially, experts predicted that with the world gradually dealing with the pandemic, the demand for semiconductors would reduce, giving manufacturing companies some breathing space to catch up with waiting orders. Unfortunately, that did not turn out to be the case. Instead, demand is on the rise. Why is this so? Let's look at the automotive industry. When the pandemic hit, the sales of cars immediately dropped. And with lockdowns in place, not many people were thinking of buying new cars. More so, people were more concerned about their financial stability rather than splashing out cash on expensive cars. Because of this, automakers did the most logical thing at the time: scale back production. Obviously, they did not anticipate that there would be such a high demand for chips in 2020, that by the time production was brought back to scale, they would find themselves at the end of long queues for chips. Frankly, no one saw it coming. However, the industry is trying to accommodate the present situation by expanding its capacity. For instance, TSMC has announced that it will be investing an additional $100 billion to expand its capacity over the next 3 years. In the same line, Samsung, alongside SK Hynix and the South Korean government, has pledged to invest $451 billion to increase capacity and incentivize chipmakers. While these huge investments are laudable and they are definitely welcome, perhaps what is more important for the industry is to reduce its reliance on Taiwan and South Korea. This really is the biggest problem. You'd be surprised to hear this, but America only produces 10% of the chips it uses. That number is remarkably low for a country that is at the forefront of technological innovation in chip design. Beside this, the fact that the US is heavily reliant on Taiwan, a country that has very close ties with China, must be a huge concern for the American military. So it's no surprise that President Biden has kept a watchful eye over the semiconductor manufacturing industry and has pledged to support this sector as part of the Build Back Better plan, which has been proposed by his administration to boost America's manufacturing industry. In addition to this, a recently introduced bipartisan tech funding will pump some $52 billion into the chip producing industry in the US. Intel is also looking to ramp up chip production. The company has unveiled plans to spend up $20 billion on two new chip manufacturing facilities in Arizona. With all these new development plans we are seeing in the industry, when will the global chip shortage end? The short answer to this question is that no one knows. Right now, no prediction can be trusted, as the global chip production industry is as unpredictable as it could possibly be. The current investments to boost capacity will not have an immediate impact on the industry, at least not until late 2023. And some experts believe that the shortage may last for that long. There are even some who believe it could be longer. That said, it is believed that the final quarter of 2021 will give us a clearer insight into how much longer the shortage will last. Typically, demands for semiconductors usually ease off in the fourth quarter of the year. And if that happens, the manufacturers may just get the break they so desperately need to catch up with demands. But for now, it's still too early to tell if demand will reduce or not. Even if demand does reduce, it is unlikely that it will be severe enough to establish a balance between supply and demand. So it's safe to say that we'll be going into 2022 with the shortage still in place, while we remain hopeful that by the end of 2022, things will be back to normal. And that's where I'd be ending this video. Thank you for watching through till the end. If you haven't already done so, kindly give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel. Also, click on the bell icon so you never miss any upcoming video. Goodbye and see you next time.